SundaySchoolGirl.com. You already know that I'm basically like your super cool auntie who just happens to teach Sunday school, and I'm here to get you ready for this Sunday, April 26th. Hope you've had a wonderful week wherever you are, that you're getting all of your schoolwork done. I don't know what your schedules are like, but mine has been very busy, but I've gotten a lot of good work done, and I'm excited that it's the weekend. Don't know what you do on your weekends, but I try to find something different, something kind of fun, even though I don't get to leave home. So last Saturday, I made a wreath for my front door. I'd never done that before, and I'll drop in a picture. You can see what it looks like. But it was kind of fun. It was different for me because I don't always do a lot of crafts. And this weekend, I'm going to try to make homemade rolls. And I don't know who's going to eat them, but I hear I can freeze them and maybe I can eat them later. But I hope that you'll do something fun with your family. And I do hope that you'll spend some time reading God's Word and being ready for Sunday school. Maybe your Sunday schools are meeting by Zoom, or maybe this is the only Sunday school you have right now. But either way, God's Word is important to us, and I don't want to leave that out of your schedule. So this week, our lesson is entitled, The Lord Loves Justice. Now, you're probably already thinking, didn't we just talk about justice last week? Well, we did. And we did the week before, and the week before that, because our entire quarter is about justice. So we're going to talk about it this week, and next week, and the week after that, all the way to the end of May, which only means that it is a really important subject, and there are so many things that we can learn about it. So this week, we're in the book of Isaiah. I want you to read all of Isaiah chapter 61. There are only 11 verses. And then read over the first 5 verses in chapter 62. That'll give you kind of the entire context of what we're talking about. We're looking at the major prophet Isaiah again, and we talked about him a few weeks ago. A major prophet doesn't mean that he was any better than anybody else, but it means he prophesied for a longer time, and he just has more work to show for the time that he prophesied in the kingdom. So before we get into the lesson, I have a question. When is the last time you received some really good news? And what was that good news? How did it make you feel? Well, that's what's going on in Isaiah chapter 61. We've been talking about God's people and how they had some difficulty really aligning with God's expectations. And so there were consequences for them to face. And that consequence was that they were going to be taken into captivity by the Babylonians. And we've talked about that in recent weeks. So as we look at this lesson, this is still in that time when they've been in captivity, and they are kind of feeling like, where is God? Does God love us? Does he care about us? Are we still his people? And here is a prophet, who is Isaiah, who comes with some really good news. And the good news is that they had a bright future up ahead. Even though they were looking at things that were crazy, even though they were in a space that wasn't their home, even though everything that they had lost, there was a future time, and God was going to give them restoration. He was going to put things back. He was going to make things better for them. So as we look at Isaiah chapter 61, you'll see in the beginning that this prophet sort of blossoms out of nowhere as a mouthpiece for God. God raises up this prophet. God selects this man to be able to bring good news to his people. And you'll understand why I chose the word blossom in just a moment. But he blossoms, and he has this message for God's people. And in this chapter, you're going to see that we learn about God's grace. You see God's comfort. And you'll see that things are going to change from the ugliness they see now to be something really great in the future. So in chapter 61, we start at verse 8 in our actual lesson. And here we learn that God loves justice. And we've been seeing that God has things that he really likes, and he has things that he doesn't like. And he's very clear that he loves justice. He loves when people are treated fairly. What was unfair? Well, what was really unfair is that the Babylonians had taken everything from God's people, even the way they took them into captivity. And so God was going to show justice, administer justice for his people. He was going to deliver his people. And the Babylonians were going to have to give an account for what they had done. And so we see that God hates, he hates when people rob. He hates when people oppress others. He hates when people lie. He hates when people steal. But he loves justice. How are you? Good. All right, that was my male lady, and I'm not going to stop and re-record. That means that I love people in my neighborhood, and we're happy to see each other. But we know that justice is important to God. And he was concerned about the Babylonians having abused his people. But again, he was also going to remember his people and reward them in the future for their work. Why? Because he had a covenant with his people. What's a covenant? A covenant is an agreement. It's when two people get together and they agree to do certain things. And when they agree, both parties understand what is supposed to happen, and each party has to hold up their end of the deal. Well, God had a covenant with his people. And no, I hate bugs too. And no matter what happened to them, no matter when they got off track or maybe they did something wrong, God always loved his people and he was always going to honor his covenant. In fact, he says the covenant wasn't just for a short time. The covenant wasn't just with their ancestors, but the covenant was everlasting. It would be forever. And so Isaiah hears this news and shares this news, and he decides in verse 10 that I am going to rejoice. There is a rejoicing that blossoms out of his soul. And he says, my soul is excited. I'm going to be happy. Why? Because God has given me beautiful new clothes. He's clothed me with righteousness, and he's made me, if you think about a bride on her wedding day or a groom on the wedding day, think about the beautiful clothes that they wear. And he's saying that God has given me new clothes. He's given me a reason to rejoice. I hear all of this good news, and for these reasons, I am going to rejoice. I chose today to record outside again, even though I hate the bugs and my neighbors are driving by, but I wanted you to see the earth bringing forth its bud. It is springtime, and so things here are starting to bloom. The trees all have their leaves back. All of my roses have bloomed. I have roses here, I have roses on the other side. It's great to see that the earth has blossomed, and that's what verse 11 says, that in the wintertime, think about it, these were dead. Maybe there were seeds in the ground. I actually cut these things all the way down under, like shorter than my knee, but the earth, because it is springtime, is bringing forth its bud. In other words, the things that we saw hidden underground would not be hidden anymore, and that's what God was saying about his people. His people had been like seeds in the earth, but when God did good work in them, they were going to be on display. They'd be like these beautiful roses, and everybody who drives by, everybody who sees them would see their incredible beauty. They would see the work of God done in them, and he said it would be everyone. All the nations were going to see this. And the Gentiles, even the people who didn't believe in God, they too would see how beautiful God is working in his people. And God was going to give them a new name. Didn't matter what people called them in the past. People called them desolate. People called them ruined. People called them washed up. But God called them by a new name. And he gave them a new name because he had a special assignment for them. They had special relationship with him. And they were never going to forget that. When God does something in you, when God comes into your heart, when he comes into your life, it is something that is big, it is something that is obvious, and it is something that is on display. Everybody can see when God is operating and working in your life. I'm done talking, but there are a couple of things that I want you to remember in this week's lesson. As we've talked about my roses blossoming and just blossoming in God, I want you to know that when you receive God's love and God's spirit, you too, like this prophet, can rise up. You can blossom and be someone who can speak a word of comfort or a word of encouragement to your families. You can speak encouragement to your friends. You can speak encouragement to yourself because God equips us to do that. The second thing that I want you to know is that when you rise up, when the love of God rises up in you, it blossoms in you and it allows you to do good things for other people in the earth. Good things for others in the earth. And that is the way that we represent God. Remember, we reflect God's heart. We're made in God's image, and He expects us to speak out against injustice. So we're all blossoming into people that God will put on display. We're blossoming into people that God will use. In the spirit of blossom, I'm done with the lesson. I want to invite you to follow a ministry that I've been connected with this week. In fact, I'm so proud of them. The ministry name is Blossom, and it is a ministry actually for young women, teen girls who are interested in connecting with amazing friends who love God, who have Christian values, and they had their very first Zoom call on today, and they're awesome. So I'm going to drop in their information here, and you can follow on Instagram, you can follow on Facebook, and on their next Zoom call, wouldn't it be blossom for you to be connected to that group of people? Everybody have a great rest of your week. Have a great weekend. I'm going to try to get a TikTok done tomorrow. I don't know what I'm doing, but I'm going to do that tomorrow too. Y'all have a good weekend, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.